If you are able, please stand and remain standing for the national anthem and the presentation of colors.
Good afternoon. Please be seated. Thank you to Phoebus High School Junior ROTC Color Guard for the presentation of colors, and to Juwan Brown, Anna Hubbard, and Lanasia Walls for that wonderful rendition of our national anthem. My name is Keisha Samuels, Interim Dean for Community Partnerships and Student Success. On behalf of the College Board, faculty, administration, and staff, we extend a warm welcome to you. We are extremely delighted that you joined us today in recognition of our 54th commencement exercises and the first commencement ceremony of Virginia Peninsula Community College. Today, we honor our Virginia Peninsula students, soon to be our Virginia Peninsula graduates, for successfully completing the requirements for an associate's degree or career studies certificate. Today's ceremony marks the culmination of years of hard work, dedication, and determination demonstrated by these students. We are filled with pride and joy as we celebrate the accomplishments of the class of 2023. We are also happy to have with us many distinguished guests sharing in this celebration this afternoon. Please hold your applause until all guests have been recognized. Representing the City of Hampton, Vice Mayor Jimmy Gray, Councilman Chris Bowman, Councilman Stephen Brown, Councilwoman Hope L. Harper, Councilman Billy Hobbs, Councilwoman Martha Mugler. Representing Hampton City Schools, Superintendent Dr. Jeffrey Smith, Deputy Superintendent Dr. John Caggiano, Chief of Secondary School Leadership Dr. Raymond Haynes. Representing Hampton City School Board, the Honorable Dr. Richard Mason, Chair. The Honorable Stephanie Jackson Afanja. The Honorable Jason Samuels. The Honorable Dr. Reginald Woodhouse. From Hampton City Schools, the Director of Academies of Hampton, Ms. Veronica Hurd. And also Hampton City Schools administrators. Representing the City of Newport News, Mayor Philip Jones. Representing the City of Williamsburg, City Manager Andrew Trivette. It is also my pleasure to introduce members of the Virginia Peninsula Community College Local Board. Ms. Mary Bunting, representing the City of Hampton. Mr. David Durham, representing York County. Mr. Joseph Fuentes, representing James City County. Ms. Tawana Golson, representing James City County. Mr. Michael F. Coombs, representing the City of Newport News. Mr. Alan Melton, representing the City of Pocosin. Dr. Keisha Melvin, representing the City of Newport News. Dr. Linda Rivera, representing York County. Dr. Jonathan Romero, representing the City of Hampton. Dr. Vince Warren, representing the City of Hampton. And Dr. Donna Woods, representing the City of Hampton. In our stage party this evening, Mr. Jeff Bonavita, Grand Marshal, Dr. Carrie Ragno, Vice President, Academic Affairs, Dr. Janetta Hollins, Interim Vice President, Enrollment Management and Student Success, Mr. Michael Todd Estes, Vice President, Workforce Development, Mr. Stephen Felker, Director of Institutional Research and Effectiveness, Ms. Ada Badgley, Chief of Staff and Director of Strategic Initiatives, Ms. Mylia Kearns, Interim Dean of the Science, Technology, Engineering, and Mathematics Division. Robert Askew, Interim Dean of the Arts, Business, Humanities, and Social Sciences Division. Mr. Paul Long, Dean of Public Safety, Allied Health, and Human Services Division. Ms. Jenny Jones, Director of Allied Health. Ms. Beth Dickens, Associate Dean of the Science, Technology, Engineering, and Mathematics. Mr. Franz Albertini, Director of Workforce Enrollment and Retention. Katie Forrester, Director of Learning Resources. Doris Taylor, Interim Director of Marketing, Communications, and Public Relations. Natalia Rodriguez, SGA President. Louis Silverman, Student Automotives, and Alma Alviar, Student Nursing. Addressing you later this afternoon is Dr. Jeffrey Smith, Hampton City Schools Superintendent, and our commencement speaker. Mayor Philip Jones. Both will be formally introduced later in the program. At this time, please extend a welcome and round of applause for our ninth president of Virginia Peninsula Community College, Dr. Tawana Porter Brannon.
Good afternoon, graduates. During my speaking, I'm going to ask for some audience participation, right? So that was good. We're going to go one more time. When I point at you, that means you get to say something, right? All right, so one more time. Good afternoon, graduates.
Yeah.
Fabulous. All righty. Well, in addition to our graduates, good afternoon to the proud family members, your loved ones, and this amazing graduating class of 2023. On behalf of Virginia Peninsula Community College, esteemed faculty, our administrators, our alumni, the College Board, the Education Foundation Board members, it is my distinct honor to celebrate your achievements and applaud you for reaching this incredible milestone. Today, we recognize what you have accomplished, but also what you have sacrificed and the hurdles that you have overcome in pursuit of higher education and training, and a life now filled with great opportunities. Each one of you is living proof that anything is possible with dedication, the support of those around you, perseverance, and a strong commitment to your goal. Now, before the ceremony concludes, you're going to hear a lot of speeches. You're going to hear from a lot of folks who are really excited to see you here today. And you're going to hear from the esteemed members of your graduating class. Each one of them is going to bring you a message of inspiration. And when you get home tonight, if there's anything you remember, I'd like you to reflect on how big of a deal this moment is, how significant this moment is. As you walk around town in your caps and gowns and people are like, congratulations, I don't want you to brush it off, right? I want you to recognize that it is not easy. Graduating from college is no small feat. Raise your hand if this journey was really easy for you. There's always one. You should be very, very proud of yourself because this is a big deal. Okay, so class of 2023, I want you to say big deal. I'm gonna say this is, and you're gonna say a big deal. Ready? Except for the one lady who raised her hand and said it was really easy. Okay? So class of 2023, this is
a big deal.
That is awesome. That is awesome. Give yourselves a round of applause. All right. So one more moment of some audience participation, right? I'm going to count to three, and I need you all to clap, but just once. Okay? Just once. It's a warm-up. Okay. One, two, three. You're amazing. You're amazing. All right. So I'm going to ask you to clap. I'm going to point at you if this refers to you, right? If this refers to you, clap once, all right? Clap once if there was someone who doubted that you'd make it here today. Make sure you send them a selfie of you, your caps and gowns. All right. Clap once if you're the first person in your family to graduate from college. Congratulations. Clap once if you worked at least one job or served in the military while attending college. All right. Clap once if you had financial struggles while you were attending college. Oh, y'all clapped real quick for that one. Clap once if you were parenting or taking care of someone else's needs while attending college. Now clap once if you know someone who started college and never got to finish. Okay. Your accomplishment today is a really big deal, right? Don't let anyone tell you that this is not a significant accomplishment. We are very proud of you. If graduating college was easy, everyone would do it. So I want you to remember as you go through the day that this is an incredible milestone. For some of you, it may be the last commencement ceremony, and for some of you, you're on to many more. This is a big deal. Now, before we move on, I would like to ask the graduates today who are still currently enrolled in high school to please stand. students that you see in front of you were not only completing the requirements for their high school diplomas, but like many of you, they were also working part-time and taking care of family members. That is not easy to do. We are very, very, very proud of you. I would like to recognize the students who will today receive their college degree and in a few short weeks receive their high school diploma. And I would like to acknowledge that today we are very proud to announce that the 100th student from Phoebus's ACE Academy is receiving their associate's degree at the same time they'll get a high school diploma. Congratulations. You may be seated. Now, you may have heard the great Nelson Mandela is known for saying that education is the most powerful weapon which you could use to change the world. And graduates, you have the power to make a difference in your communities and the world around you. This graduation ceremony signals the beginning of a new chapter in your life. You have made a sound investment in your social and economic mobility, an investment that we are sure will pay off not only for you, but for your children, your entire family, and the generations to come. As you move forward in life, I encourage you to remember the lessons that you learned while enrolled in college, both inside and outside of the classroom, the skills that you've acquired and the knowledge that you have gained, and use them to pursue your passions and achieve your goals. I encourage you to seek out new and sometimes maybe scary experiences. Travel often, meet new people, and challenge yourself. I also encourage you to stay connected to Virginia Peninsula Community College. We truly are inspired by you. We want to know how your life is going. We want you to tag us when you get your first job or when you go on to a four-year institution. Keep in touch with us. Email me directly. We are inspired by you, and we want to follow you as you go on through your life. Now, graduates, today is technically your day. However, we would be remiss if we did not also recognize everyone here who has sacrificed along with you to help you along the journey. And since Sunday is Mother's Day, I would like you all to give a round of applause to your moms, your aunties, your big sisters, your daughters. And all the males in your life who have supported you like a mom would. Congratulations once again, graduates. May your future be bright and filled with endless possibilities. And thank you for letting Virginia Peninsula Community College be a part of your incredible journey. Enjoy the rest of your ceremony. All right. I am now happy to turn the podium over to Ms. Katie Fortier, the Director for Learning and Resources, for the presentation of our student awards. Ms. Fortier, please join me.
Good afternoon. I'm Katie Fortier, Director for Learning Resources. It is my pleasure to present the Class of 2023 Student Awards. First, the Vice President's Award. This recognition is awarded to a graduate who represents the highest standards of academic achievement and social responsiveness within the graduating class. Applicants for the award must excel academically, earning a 3.9 GPA, contribute time and talents on and off campus, and be recommended by a faculty member. This year, the Vice President's Award goes to Alma Avalar. Alma Avalar lives in Mechanicsville, Virginia. She is a licensed practical nurse in a long-term acute care hospital at Vibra Hospital of Richmond, Virginia. After graduating from John Randolph Tucker High School, Alma moved to California, where she attended a vocational school and obtained her LPN license. Alma entered Virginia Peninsula Community College in spring 2020 to pursue an associate degree of applied science in nursing. Despite the challenges and obstacles faced as a DACA recipient and first-generation college student, she persisted and persevered. Her hard work and dedication to academic excellence paid off. She maintained a 4.0 GPA, was inducted into Phi Theta Kappa, in spring 2022 and served as class co-secretary for the Student Nurses Association. According to Alma, her dedication to academic excellence and community involvement shaped her into the compassionate and driven individual she is today. Alma describes her experience at Virginia Peninsula Community College as positive and life-changing. She stated the following: "It was with the help of VPCC's supportive community and rigorous nursing program, I can achieve my dream of becoming a soon-to-be registered nurse in the emergency department. The inclusive culture and dedication to diversity at VPCC made me feel appreciated and at home. I am grateful for the knowledge and motivation I obtained during my time here." Starting in August, Alma will serve as a registered nurse in the emergency room at Forest and Henrico's Doctors Hospital. Beginning fall 2024, her plans also include pursuing a Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Alma's ultimate career goal and passion lie in becoming a trauma-certified registered nursing working as a flight nurse. Please welcome award recipient Alma Avalar to the podium.
Dear distinguished guests, esteemed staff and faculty, beloved family and friends, and most importantly, the exceptional graduates of today, I am humbled and grateful for the opportunity to accept this prestigious award from Virginia Peninsula Community College. It is a true honor to receive this recognition for my hard work and dedication, and I will cherish this moment for years to come. As I reflect on my journey, I am reminded of a remarkable speech given by DeMarco Jackson, an alumnus of Hermitage High School, during his commencement ceremony in 2015. He battled severe aplastic anemia, MDS, and PNH, which are two different types of cancer that attack the bone marrow. DeMarco Jackson passed away shortly after graduation, but his words continue to resonate with me and serve as a testament to his enduring impact on those who knew him and had the privilege to hear his message. DeMarco's words of advice, and I quote, "Do not let the realities of the past or the possibilities of the future negatively affect the peace, joy, and happiness that the present has to offer." Those words have left a profound impact on me. We often become consumed by our past mistakes and fear for the future, failing to appreciate the moment, the present moment, and the good fortune we have in our lives. To overcome these obstacles, we must focus on the present, live in the moment, and work to achieve our goals. Additionally, DeMarco's words about education and acceptance have also resonated with me. He stressed the importance of putting effort into attaining knowledge and avoid judging others for who they are. If we welcome diversity and refrain from criticizing others for being different, we can remove barriers and construct bridges that connect us to people from all walks of life. By embracing differences in tradition, history, and perspective, we can all learn from each other and make the world a more accepting place. In closing, I want to express my deep gratitude for this award and the educational opportunities provided by Virginia Peninsula Community College. I am excited to use what I have learned in my future endeavors and to continue celebrating change, seeking knowledge, and living in the present moment. Thank you once again for this incredible honor.
Dr. Ragno, please come forward to present the Vice President's Award. On behalf of our Vice President for Academic Affairs and the entire Virginia Peninsula Community College family, we are proud to present Alma Avalar with the 2023 Vice President's Award. I would now like to welcome Ms. Jenny Jones, Director of Allied Health, to the podium to present the President's Award.
It is my pleasure to present the President's Award. This year, the award goes to Lewis W. Silverman. Lewis William Silverman, who is known across the college as Lou, born in New York in 1948, Lou grew up in Great Neck, and after graduating from high school, he worked various jobs in the automotive industry before enlisting in the U.S. Coast Guard in 1967. While serving, he visited several countries and performed engineering duties. He later rejoined the military, the U.S. Army Reserve in Florida, as a track vehicle mechanic, and continued to work in the automotive industry. He also became active in the Coral Springs Volunteer Fire Department. After moving to Virginia, he became a military technician and an individual mobilization augmentee for the Army Reserve, serving in several units and supporting various missions, including the Dayton Peace Accords in Hungary and the War on Terror in Uzbekistan, Kuwait, and New Jersey. He retired in 2008 as a first sergeant with a combined 39 years of active and reserve service. At age 73, Lou enrolled at Virginia Peninsula Community College in the summer of 2021 to pursue an Associate of Applied Science in Automotive Technology. He is currently an adjunct instructor in VPCC's Automotive Technology Department. For the 2022 to 2023 academic year, he served as president of Phi Theta Kappa and president of Student Veterans of America Peninsula Chapter. He was also a member of the Advisory Council on Diversity, Equity, Inclusion, and Culture, as well as a student ambassador. He volunteers at VPCC's Food Pantry and Clothes Closet. Since 2019, Lou has also been a longtime volunteer firefighter, a member of Newport News' Civilian Emergency Response Team, and a One City Marathon volunteer. Please help me give a warm welcome to Lewis William Silverman.
Good afternoon, Dr. Brannon, Dr. Ragno, Dr. Hollins, members of the College Board, distinguished guests, faculty and staff, friends of the college, and especially my fellow graduates of the Virginia Peninsula Community College class of 2023. Roar! My best gator, sorry. I'm Lou Silverman, First Sergeant, United States Army retired, and recent graduate of the Automotive Technology Degree Program here at Virginia Peninsula Community College. What a wonderful day it is to be alive. If you had asked me back in the summer of 2021, when I started my most recent academic journey here at Virginia Peninsula Community College, where I would be on this day 2 years hence, the very last place I would have told you would have been here on this magnificent stage in this glorious building, accepting an award for my academic achievements. But here I am, and I might have to pinch myself because this seems like a dream from where I stand, so ouch. Let me tell you that I believe there are no new secrets to success. Everyone already knows them all or did at one time. They even sell posters and bumper stickers about them at the store at the mall. So please indulge me for a moment while I share a few of my oldies but goodies. Being with you all here, two of the many things I learned in life come immediately to mind. The first is to never sell yourself short. Always remember that you can accomplish anything if you set your heart and mind to it. Anything. But no one will be handing it to you. Excellence of any kind takes hard work. Second, and maybe just as importantly, is to never settle for doing less than your best. Make it a habit to always do the best job possible. You should never be happy with anything less. My motto, shared with me by one of my mentors, Major General Dexter Tudor, United States Air Force, has been to do whatever it takes to get the job done. It has never failed me. Find something that works for you and live by it every day. I hope all of my fellow graduates will be able to reflect back on their time spent at Virginia Peninsula and smile. I know I will. I used to tell people that if you found me with a frown on my face, You'd have to check my pulse. Not to say that there weren't some tense moments, we had them all, but I enjoyed my time here as a student and the friends who helped, I beg your pardon, as a student here, so many incredible memories. Treasure those memories and the friends who helped make them. Life goes by too quickly as it is. Many of you will head out for further academic adventures and some will return to the workforce. Never forget where you came from and who helped you up to where you are. Someone always has your back. Finally, I would be remiss if I did not take more than a moment to remember on this Red Friday the many active duty reserve and National Guard, as well as our retiree and veteran students and their families celebrating with us here today, and thank them for their service to our nation. God bless you, and God bless our deployed troops. I will be staying around for a while, or for a little longer anyway, still trying to make our college a better place than it was when I started here. Wish me luck. Congratulations, class of 2023, and my best wishes to all of you. Thank you.
Dr. Brannon, please come forward to present the President's Award.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am.
On behalf of our college president and the entire college, we are proud to present Lewis Silverman with the 2023 President's Award. Now we clap. I would now like to welcome to the podium Shaheem Abrams, biology professor in the Science, Technology, Engineering, and Mathematics Division.
Good afternoon. In 2010, the College Board established the Dana B. Hamill Award to honor individuals or organizations for their commitment to public service, to foster access to higher education, and promoting an understanding of the role of workforce development as an essential part of the college's mission. The award is named in honor of Dr. Dana B. Hamill, the first chancellor of Virginia Community Colleges, and an individual who personifies the attributes associated with this recognition. I'm honored to announce that the recipient of this year's Dana B. Hamill Award is Dr. Jeffrey Smith, superintendent of Hampton City Schools. Dr. Smith began his tenure as superintendent of Hampton City Schools on July 15, 2015. Under his leadership, Hampton City Schools experienced its highest academic success in decades for the first time in the school's history. 100% of the school's 29 schools became accredited without conditions. The school division strengthened its dual enrollment program with Virginia Peninsula Community College, yielding a 750% increase in concurrent coursework completed over the past 5 years. Hampton City Schools' on-time graduation rate increased from 88% for the class of 2015 to 97.64% for the class of 2022. The dropout rate decreased from 5.1% for the class of 2015 to less than 1% for the class of 2022. Over the past 3 years, Dr. Smith co-chaired the Academies of Hampton. The academies provide young people with opportunities to prepare for high-wage jobs aligned with regional and state workforce demands. He believes transformational approach to education will ultimately prepare young people to be college, career, and life ready. This important work was featured in the 2018 State of the Region report as the next generation of learning in Hampton Roads, as well as the Center for American Progress, as one of the four educational models working across the country. Dr. Smith was a 2019 recipient of the Peninsula Humanitarian Award from the Virginia Center for Inclusive Communities. He was named Region 2 Superintendent of the Year and the 2020 Virginia Superintendent of the Year. He's the recipient of the 2020 Mary Peake Award for Excellence in Educational Equity. In 2021-22, the Virginia District Exchange Club presented him with its Distinguished Virginian Award. And in 2023, Dr. Smith received the Presidential Award for Outstanding Citizenship from Hampton University. The scope of Dr. Smith's life's work personifies the spirit of the Dana B. Hemmel Award. While his professional success is undeniable and quantifiable, who he is as a man is even more special. At this time, I would like to introduce Dr. Donna Woods, a member of the VPCC board and retired executive director for secondary school leadership with Hampton City Schools, who will share some special attributes that you may not find in Dr. Smith's bio. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Donna Woods.
Thank you so much, Dr. Abraham, for that warm welcome. And good afternoon to our graduates. This is a big deal. Congratulations to you. And to our families and distinguished guests, I am honored to share insights about our Dana B. Hemmel Award honoree, Dr. Jeffrey Smith. Like Dr. Hemmel, Dr. Smith has dedicated his life to outstanding public service. Dr. Hemmel will celebrate his 100th birthday on August 9th and credits his longevity to faith and optimism. In 2020, at the age of 97, Dr. Hemmel reflected on his work with the Virginia Community College System that spanned from 1967 to 2007, and I quote, "There was a feeling that we needed to do more for the people of Virginia and help them prepare for jobs that require more than a high school education. Our community colleges were an investment in our future, and people responded." You'll find that both Dr. Smith and Dr. Hemmel are humble and compassionate leaders who not only wanted and want to do more for the people they serve, but to empower people to serve and see their future they deserve and help them to achieve that future. Dr. Smith has the ability to look ahead while not losing sight of the person in front of him. He has been an inspiration in my life and in the lives of many. He models how to enjoy and thrive and love working in public education alongside parents and community partners with his warm, jovial, patient, and caring demeanor. Dr. Smith has genuinely cared about my life outside of work, remembering important events and checking on my family. But he doesn't just do that for me. This is who he is and what he does. Dr. Smith is a visible, available, and relatable person. He loops through the central office building, tapping on doors to peek his head in to say hello, do a check and connect, share a little story. He is also committed to staying healthy, so sometimes I think he does this as a way to get his steps in. As you speak with him, it is clear that his faith and family are very dear to him. He speaks fondly about his family and always looks forward to hearing updates about their accomplishments and achievements of his beautiful wife, Dr. Lorianne Smith, and two wonderful children, Lauren and Joshua, the apples of his eye. When Dr. Smith arrived in 2015, he told the Hampton community that we were collectively building from places of strength. That was so beautiful. It acknowledged all the work we had done, and we're building from places of strength. And it's characteristic of his optimism and positive outlook. After his Look, Listen, and Learn tour of the community, he deployed a laser-like focus on systems change. Dr. Smith worked tirelessly over the past 8 years, visioning and supporting the team and the community to invest in the future, holding expectations of greatness from himself and challenging staff and students in the community to be great. He fosters continual improvement towards bold and bodacious goals, providing staff opportunities to grow, develop, and build the requisite capacity. He offers frequent praise and pats on the back. We knew we had a level 5 leader as defined in Jim Collins' book, Good to Great, as we observed Dr. Smith demonstrate personal humility combined with integrity, a ferocious will, and unparalleled knowledge of curriculum, teaching, learning, and leadership. Guiding the One Division, One Transformation pre-K through 12 strategies to prepare young people for post-secondary success. As school district leaders, we quickly learned that in God, Dr. Smith trusted. Everyone else needed to bring data to whatever was affectionately known as our success meetings, which were held biweekly. Dr. Smith loves the facts and uses data to drive improvement. He has an uncanny ability to ask the right questions. He didn't tell me what to do. He simply asked the right questions. Sometimes he had to rephrase it for me a couple of times, which he patiently did. And using our collective experience, he helped me derive the path forward towards those bold goals. I could see the twinkle in his eye, the smile on his face, and the excitement that would build as we collaborated and converged on the data-driven path forward. Dr. Smith is a true servant leader who believes every child can learn. By holding higher expectations for ourselves and our students, we could achieve greatness together as a community through excellent teaching, learning, and leadership. We celebrate another manifestation of his vision and commitment to greatness today as we honor Hannah Bunting, a senior from Kickatan High School and the Gov School, along with the 40 graduates of the phenomenal Phoebus High School Academy of the College Experience who are obtaining their associate degrees before their high school diplomas, well on their way to post-secondary success. Superintendents and leaders across the country revere Dr. Smith. His peers seek his wisdom and insight as they grow their talents and expertise. The U.S. Secretary of Education, Miguel Cardona, visited Hampton Schools this past Monday to learn about the College and Career Academy transformation led by Dr. Smith and shared that Bethel High School is the type of school he would like his children to attend. The secretary celebrated the culture at Bethel, and Dr. Smith is the culture of Hampton City Schools. His work reminds me of a stanza from Longfellow's A Psalm of Life. Lives of great men all remind us we can make our lives sublime, and departing leave behind us footprints on the sands of time. Dr. Smith's extraordinary leadership and public service to our community has left indelible footprints and a legacy that will endure and serve as an example for each of us as we strive towards achieving greatness in our lives and in our communities. He has modeled how we can pursue something bigger than ourselves to prepare for whatever may come by working diligently today for a better tomorrow. Congratulations to our graduates. Be kind, be well, be authentic, be you. At this time, if you would please help me welcome the 2023 Dana B. Hamill Award honoree, my former boss, my friend, and my colleague, Dr. Jeffrey Smith. Stay for the picture.
Dr. Smith, the mission of Virginia Peninsula Community College is to change lives and transform communities. You personify the mission of this college, and on behalf of our board, it gives me great honor to present you with this year's Dana B. Hamill Award.
Good afternoon. Members of the College Board, President Porter Brannan, faculty and staff, elected officials, members of the Hampton City School Board, City Manager Bunting, members of the class of 2023, and distinguished guests. To include members of my senior cabinet, I'm going to ask that they would kindly stand. All of the members of the division leadership team and school board members of Hampton, please stand, because I share this with you and the faculty and the administration of Hampton City Schools. Please stand. Please know that I am humbled and honored to receive the 2023 Dana B. Hamill Award. It has been my absolute pleasure to serve the community and to partner with the Virginia Peninsula Community College. Since 2015, our young people have earned over 25,000 dual enrollment credits, not including the dual enrollment credits earned this academic year. Please give them a round of applause. Together, Madam President, together we have celebrated with students and families of 103 young scholars of Hampton City Schools who graduated their senior year in high school with an associate degree from the Virginia Peninsula Community College. We are proud of you. Indeed, it has been our goal to foster access to higher education and to prepare young people to be college, career, and life ready. A proud hallmark of this important journey has been transforming our high schools from pocket academies to 16 wall-to-wall academies and from 18 career pathway options to now 44 career pathways. Members of our school board and members of the division leadership team, join me as the superintendent in expressing our gratitude and appreciation for the partnership opportunities to engage in the work of fulfilling our core mission of teaching and learning as we work to realize our mission of academic excellence for every child, every day, whatever it takes. My brief word of wisdom is simply to make it your mission to fulfill your greater purpose in life and to remember that you will lose some of what you go after some of the time, but you will lose all of what you choose to not go after all of the time. Go after making this world a better place for you and for me and the entire human race. What I hope will long remain as a hallmark of my journey in Hampton City Schools is what Robert Frost poetically framed as the road less traveled. Yes, I shall be telling this with a sigh. Somewhere ages and ages hence, two roads diverged in a wood, and I and we took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. It is the road where we believe that all children can achieve. It is the road where we understand that all children are deserving of the opportunity to achieve. And it is the road whereby we accept the responsibility of providing the appropriate resources to ensure our young people are college, career, and life ready. It has been the road in which my wife sings about on Sunday mornings, when she says, if I can help somebody as I pass along this way, then my living shall not be in vain. The road of paying it forward. May God bless each of you as we all continue to realize and keep in the forefront what Mary McLeod Methuen said, believe in yourself, learn, and never stop wanting to build a better world. President Brannon, members of the College Board, and members of the Leadership Cabinet, thank you, and may the wind always be at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face, the rains fall soft upon your fields, and until we meet again, may God hold you in the palm of his hand. Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Beth Dickens, Associate Dean of the Science, Technology, Engineering, and Mathematics Division. Again, welcome College Board, faculty, administration, and staff. I am truly honored today to introduce our keynote commencement speaker, Newport News Mayor Philip D. Jones. Philip D. Jones is the 27th mayor of Newport News. When he was sworn in January 10th, 2023, he became the city's youngest elected mayor at the age of 33. For the past decade, he has served in leadership roles in the public and private sectors. As a Marine Corps infantry officer, he led his Marines to support peacekeeping and security cooperation missions on multiple continents. As a management consultant with a leading global firm, he advised Fortune 500 companies, municipalities, and nonprofits on strategy, marketing, organization, and operations across all industries. In the wake of 9/11, Mayor Jones accepted a nomination to the United States Naval Academy, where he graduated with merit with a Bachelor of Science degree in history. He earned an MBA and a Master's in Public Policy from Harvard. At Harvard Kennedy School, he was a Tillman Scholar and co-president of the Veterans Club. He graduated from Hampton Christian Academy in 2008. He spent 6 years on active duty and 4 years in the reserves. He's still serving in the reserves as a major. Please welcome the 27th mayor of Newport News, Mayor Philip D. Jones.
Thank you so much. As a politician, we really only have two rules. Number one is never give a speech in your cap. The second one is be brief, and that's what I'm gonna do. Yeah. I got you, don't worry. Good afternoon, President Brannon, VPCC faculty, staff, College Board members, distinguished guests, proud parents, family, friends, and most of all, to you, the class of 2023. It is truly an honor to stand before you on this occasion of commencement, the very first official class of Virginia Peninsula Community College graduates. I'm extremely honored by your faith in me to extol some sort of wisdom here today. That's especially true since I know that the average age of the graduating class is 26. Many of you are non-traditional students and have years of experience, life lessons that you can offer your other classmates. This is my first time as a commencement speaker, and hopefully I'll get invited back, all right? When I first started thinking about my speech today, I wasn't sure what message that I could offer. Dr. Holland suggested themes on new beginnings, integrity, excellence, adapting to change, courage, leadership, resilience. So I've decided to talk about what has worked for me so far. I'll admit, I'm a super serious and a fast-paced person. Especially in my new role as mayor, staff always tells me that I need to smile and look at the sunset. So I'm smiling right now. I'm also very efficient. I have about 6 different emails, and before I can go to bed every single night, I have to make sure all emails have been answered. I'm also brimming over with energy and excitement, especially when I'm talking about the future of the great city of Newport News. Adding that to my youth, to all my experience, people tell me to slow down all the time. So instead, I've worked hard to use that energy as a roadmap to harness my restlessness, to tackle roadblocks, and distill distractions into productivity for my personal and professional fulfillment. People always say, why did I join the Marine Corps? Why did I join infantry? I'll tell everyone, God loves the infantry, right? And it's the hardest thing that I could do out of college. For me, that's what makes life worth living, is when you're faced with challenges. I will say, though, that my body is starting to write checks that my mouth cannot cash. I can remember in the Corps, in a training accident, I broke all the fingers on my right hand, and a surgeon had to build back my hand right before a deployment. I can remember running a marathon and not training for it, thinking it's gonna be fine, which, by the way, I wanna go on record, I did finish that marathon with no training. I did break both of my feet. But I feel like whenever I have my back up against the wall is when I do my best work. And maybe that's just my way of rationalizing turning failures into success, or maybe it's just a personal coping mechanism. But you know what? I never have to worry about what I'm going to do on that day that I am faced with heartbreak or failure. It's not going to rock me to my core. And the question you may ask is why? Because I built my own personal foundation. And much of it has to do with the military culture being in my family for generations. Both of my parents were career Air Force officers. After that, they became missionaries. They raised me under the premise of to whom much is given, much will truly be required. Which means what? It means that we are held responsible for what we have. Responsible, able to respond. So the first thing that I do when I wake up is I try to go on a run. And it's more than just the working out, it's setting that discipline. I think it's the perseverance and tenacity that will get all of us through 90% of life. So what I have for the graduates is this. If you build your foundations on good habits, then it does not matter what life throws at you, because you can get up in the morning and keep going. You can close your eyes and keep putting one foot in front of the other. You do not need resiliency when you have that muscle memory. I believe that the highest performers in life take full ownership of their habits. They have chosen to create and implement good routines. Our discipline, our compassion gets baked in. Good habits just become muscle memory. Now that being said, as I close, I also believe in taking risk and seizing the day. The words of my undergrad motto is, fortune favors the bold and the brave. So I want you to take those risks early, take them often. Don't be afraid to fail. But even if you do, if you've built up that personal foundation with good habits, you'll always have that to fall back on. That perfect recipe for discipline and compassion. Rely on that tenacity to outwork everyone else and keep moving forward. Resilience will be essential for navigating the ups and downs of life. It is about developing mental and emotional strength to withstand the gut punches and heartbreak that you will experience, trust me. And believe me, I know we all know, they're coming. Resilience is the ability to bounce back from adversity, to persevere in the face of obstacles, and most importantly, to never give up on your dreams. But again, if you have your personal foundation, routine, and habits, it gives you the desire and discipline to get up again and again. It makes you able to respond or responsible for how you react to that adversity. When I think about perseverance and adversity, I think about my fiance, Jamila. She's a GI doctor. We're actually getting married next year in Jamaica, where her family's from. She's had 10 years of training in her specialty. 10 years. I'm amazed by that good habits and resiliency that she's been able to build throughout her entire career. Can you imagine all those times during the last 10 years she could have gotten completely overwhelmed and frustrated, but her body, her mind, and her will wouldn't let her. She got up every single morning and kept putting one foot in front of the other. All my good quotes, by the way, were taken by others, so I'm gonna do this on the fly. Muhammad Ali always said, "The best way to make your dreams come true is simply to wake up." It is that simple. Just wake up. Wake up and develop good habits. That way, you'll know what to do when life throws a sucker punch right at you. You'll be able to take responsibility for your reactions. You'll have the ability to respond and wake up and succeed the next day and the next day and the next. Congratulations, BPCC class of 2023. This day belongs to you.
I am Natalia Rodriguez, SGA President, and a proud member of the graduating class of 2023. Mayor Philip D. Jones, thank you for your words of wisdom. You are an inspiration to all of us. On the behalf of Virginia Peninsula Community College 2023 graduating class, we would like to present you with the token appreciation.
And that was under 8 minutes, by the way, all right?
See, double back again.
All right, now it's your turn. You guys ready? Now, before we start, make sure your tassels are on the right-hand side, okay? Make sure they're on the right-hand side, because when we get to the very end, if you mess up the turn, we have to do the whole ceremony again, so. I heard there's prom tonight. Let's get it right. All right, so next, we will have the presentation of the candidates. I would like to ask Dr. Kerry Ragno to please join me at the podium. You could clap for the Vice President of Academic Affairs.
Thank you. It is now my favorite moment, your moment, graduates. Here we go. As Vice President for Academic Affairs, I now have the pleasure of presenting to you, Dr. Brannon, the 54th graduating class and first graduating class of Virginia Peninsula Community College. Pending successful completion of their courses, these students have been approved and recommended for graduation by the faculty. Dr. Brannon, I present to you the candidates for their respective degrees and certificates. We ask the audience to please hold their applause until all degrees and certificates have been conferred. Please stand and remain standing when I call your degree or certificate. Associate of Applied Science degree candidates, please stand. Associate of Arts candidates, please stand. Associate of Fine Arts candidates, please stand. Associate of Science degree candidates, please stand. Certificate candidates and Career Studies certificate candidates. Dr. Brannon, I have the honor of presenting the candidates for the degrees of Associate of Applied Science, Associate of Arts, Associate of Fine Arts, Associate of Science, certificates, and Career Studies certificates. Many of our students have earned multiple degrees and certificates. For today's ceremony, students will be recognized for the highest earned degree.
Alrighty, you will hear your name called today. So for now, you can be seated. And ushers, please prepare to release the first row of candidates to the stage. At this time, I will ask Mr. Robert Askew, Interim Dean of Arts, Business, Humanities, and Social Science, who will begin acknowledging this year's graduates. Board members who wish to be part of the receiving line, you may stand with me at the front of the stage at this time.
Natalia Angeline Rodriguez. Abby Ross Tutone. Brendan Michael Firth. Candace Marie Davis, Associate of Science in Social Science Education. Jennifer Lynn Smith, Associate of Science in Science. Brandon Cole Sutton, Associate of Science in Social Science. Jake Quaid Ojukwu Karusi Primes, Associate of Science in Science and Computer Science. Deja Mariah Asbury, Associate of Science in Health Science. Jade Ashley DeJesus, Associate of Science in Social Science. Nancy E. Sheridan, Associate of Science in Social Science. Rebecca P. Rich, Associate of Science in Social Science. Ronald Pleasant Lewis, Associate of Science in Social Science. Jocelyn Marie White, Associate of Science in Social Science. Elijah Jemison, Associate of Science in Science. Caitlin Claire Herber, Associate of Science in Social Science. Anwuli Catherine Asoga, Associate of Science in Health Science. Kate Marie Leonard, Associate of Science in Science. Tyler Antonio Good, Associate of Science in Business Administration. Andrew Joseph Schaefer, Associate of Science in Engineering. Alexis Chantel Pigram, Associate of Science in Social Science. Harley J. Casey, Associate of Science in Health Science. Jaden Christopher Bennett, Associate of Science in Business Administration. Sean Johnston, Associate of Science in Business Administration. Hannah E. Gurley, Associate of Science in Social Science. Rebecca Ann Beaver, Associate of Science in Social Science. Pablo Veras, Associate of Science in Social Science. Dominique Andrew Hunt, Associate of Science in Social Science. Hannah Ann Marie Southers, Associate of Science in Social Science. Jose E. Vasquez Lozada, Associate of Science in Information Technology. Jared Ryan Russell, Associate of Science in Science. Jordan Nicholas Lewis Spigner, Associate of Science in Business Administration. Bryce Alexander Sales, Associate of Science in Social Science. Wyatt Mulcahy Richards, Associate of Science in Computer Science. Naomi Ross Lewis, Associate of Science in Social Science. Alexis Haley Sunday, Associate of Science in Health Science. Marissa Brianna Albert, Associate of Science in Social Science. Richard Lewis Obin, Associate of Science in Science.
Armand Bennett Judd, Associate of Science in Health Science. Brooke Connett Brown, Associate of Science in Social Science. Alora Dawn Steely, Associate of Science in Social Science. Emily Kate Johnson, Associate of Science in Business Administration. Sierra Rain Fuentes, Associate of Science in Social Science. Cheyenne Renee James, Associate of Science, Social Science. Jessica Odell Sessoms, Associate of Science in Health Science. Caitlin Elizabeth Boltick, Associate of Science in Science, Computer Science. Robert A. Meadows, Associate of Science in Social Science. Diana Evans Vernon, Associate of Science in Social Science. Tina R. Abernathy, Associate of Science in Health Science. Tiffany Ann Shugram, Associate of Science in Science. Jordan Allen Erickson, Associate of Science in Engineering. William Bailey Hudgens, Associate of Science in Business Administration. William Benson Michaelwitz, Associate of Science in Health Science. Kayla Cherie Johnson, Associate of Science in Business Administration. Jaden Powell, Associate of Science in Social Science. Jolia R. Carter, Associate of Science, Business Administration. Logan Robert Mooney, Associate of Science, Social Science. Jeanette Jacob, Associate of Science in Science. Katrina Louise Schaefer, Associate of Science in Engineering. Julie M. Booth, Associate of Science in Social Science. Brianna Marie Hart, Associate of Science in Social Science. Nazaria Daniel, Associate of Science, Computer Science. Sofika Williams, Associate of Science in Business Administration. Jasmine Alexis Brown, Associate of Science in Social Science. Malcolm Craig Ellsworth, Associate of Science in Information Technology. Skylar Jewel Horton, Associate of Science in Health Science. Sadie Marie Everett, Associate of Science in Social Science. Star Adrian Williams, Associate of Science in Health Science. Janai Amelia Sewer, Associate of Science in Health Science. Abani Precious Bird, Associate of Science in Social Science. Keisha Monique Brown, Associate of Science, Business Administration. Carlia Marcier Johnson, Associate of Science in Business Administration. Amaya Michael Rose, Associate of Science in Social Science. Jaden Amaya Lorenz, Associate of Science in Science. Ayet Nancy Bumande, Associate of Science in Social Science. Ella Alhamer, Associate of Science. Jeremiah Josiah Kaylee Hinton, Associate of Science, Social Science. Frederick Ramirez Malencia. Associate of Science, Science. Jacob Tyreek Williams, Associate of Science in Science. Brianna R. Furman, Associate of Science in Science. Sanan Brianna Simmons, Associate of Science in Science. Asia Janae Batten, Associate of Science in Science. Marcus Andre Woods, Associate of Science in Science. Joel Leon Blunt, Associate of Science in Science. Deja Monet Moore, Associate of Science in Social Science. Jalen Rashawn Sedgwick, Associate of Science in Social Science. Kennedy Sanaya Harris, Associate of Science in Social Science. Kiera Royale Taylor, Associate of Science in Social Science. Azura Desanique Jones, Associate of Science in Science. Natalia Amira Reed, Associate of Science in Science. Cameron Alea Goodman, Associate of Science in Science. Angelique Anastasia Eccles, Associate of Science in Social Science. Sean Christopher Morris, Associate of Science in Engineering. Peter Morales, Jr., Associate of Science in Science. Tricia Ann Maureen Abadia Essacrone, Associate of Science in Business Administration. Jordan Dale Leakes, Associate of Science in Science. Janiah Nicole Ellis, Associate of Science in Social Science. Tiffany Demaya White, Associate of Science in Social Science. Jordan O'Brien Bass, Associate of Science in Science. Brian M. Jackson, Associate of Science in Science. Grace Jolene Vecchio, Associate of Science in Social Science. Michaela Holcomb, Associate of Science in Social Science. Amaya Cherise Singley, Associate of Science in Social Science. Callie Phyllis Jean Bonner, Associate of Science in Science, Social Science.
Desiree Deanna Dupree. Desiree Deanna. Desiree.
Desiree Deanna Dupree, Associate of Science in Science. Chastity Renee Cooper, Associate of Science in Social Science. Ariana M. Rose, Associate of Science in Science. Elijah Isaiah Thompson, Associate of Science in Social Science. Hannah Marie Bunting, Associate of Science in Science. Hannah Marie Redd, Associate of Science in Social Science. Mallory Nicole Fisher, Associate of Science in Social Science.
Jamir Anthony Antonio Lee Callahan.
Jamir Antonio Lee Callahan, Associate of Science in Science. Kirsten Marie Starnes, Associate of Science in Science. Ethan Samuel Winnebald, Associate of Science in Science. Sanaya Monet McWilliams, Associate of Science in Health Science. Victoria Elizabeth Roman, Associate of Science in Health Science. Deja Latisse Rios, Associate of Science in Health Science. Raheem Aman Strong, Associate of Science in Social Science. Akira Renee Wallace, Associate of Science in Social Science. Josiah Josiah Eck, Associate of Science in Social Science. Tomar McL Pettis, Associate of Science in Computer Science. Kelsey Yolicker, Associate of Science in Social Science. Olivia Madeline Homola, Associate of Science in Social Science. Haley Zolakavich, Associate of Science in Business Administration. Hope Victoria Goforth, Associate of Science in Business Administration. Vincent Uyami Mendoza, Associate of Science in Business Administration. Lillian Grace Turner, Associate of Science in Social Science. Joshua Emmanuel Royal, Associate of Science in Science. Courtney Marjan Wilson, Associate of Science in Science. Taylor Alexis Hainsworth, Associate of Science in Social Science. Keyshawn Alexander King, Associate of Science in Science. Juwan Lavelle Brown, Associate of Arts in Liberal Arts. Caleb Anderson Boo Spencer, Associate of Arts in Liberal Arts Music. Anya Marcel Brown, Associate of Arts and Liberal Arts. Olivia M. Bogaloris, Associate in Arts, Liberal Arts. Deja Lee Curtis, Associate of Arts in Liberal Arts Theater Performance. Ian Shales, Associate of Arts in Liberal Arts. Emily Ruth Mainwaring, Associate of Arts in Liberal Arts. Elena Irene Eno, Associate of Arts in Liberal Arts. DeAndre Lorenzo Williams, Associate of Arts in Liberal Arts. Anaya Alea Renee Reese, Associate of Science in Health Science. LaRandia Nicole Miller, Associate of Science in Social Science. Gabrielle Miriam Lawson, Associate of Science in Social Science. Sharina Renee Marsh, Associate of Science in Social Science. Jerissa Dejanique Webb, Associate of Science in Health Science. Mona Amelia Flowers, Associate of Business in Business Administration. Donna Marie Flowers, Associate of Science in Social Science. Cassidy Faith Tallman, Associate of Science in Social Science. Tristan Javier Fingston, Associate of Science in Business Administration. Destiny Page Furch, Associate of Science in Social Science. Lee Jun Yu, Associate of Science in Business Administration. Christiana Nakia Williams, Associate of Fine Arts and Visual Arts. Warren J. Brooks, Associate of Fine Arts and Visual Arts. Vanessa Whitney, Associate of Fine Arts and Visual Arts.
Michael Anthony Parham, Associate of Fine Arts and Visual Arts. Gwendolyn Dunn, Associate of Arts and Liberal Arts. Charisse Nikkel Bullock, Associate of Arts and Liberal Arts. Isaiah Carter Whiteside, Associate of Arts and Liberal Arts, Theater Performance. Jennifer Rosemary Gray, Associate of Arts and Liberal Arts. Alma Jasmine Avalar, Associate of Applied Science and Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Lewis William Silverman, Associate of Applied Science and Automotive Technology. Elizabeth Ann Keith, Associate of Applied Science and Administrative Support Technology, Medical Office Administration. Esther Oluwasan Lawal, Associate of Applied Science and Information Systems Technology. Philip Andrew Carr, Associate of Applied Science and Graphic and Media Design. Michaela Quinn Giacchetta, Associate of Applied Science and Graphic and Media Design. Cassandra? Cassandra Marie Kelly Kahn, Associate of Applied Science and Human Services. Kendra Diane Fink, Associate of Applied Science and Human Services.
Soledad Ebene.
Anaya Soledad Ebene Walton, Associate of Applied Science in Graphic and Media Design. Connor Patrick Davis, Associate of Applied Science in Graphic and Media Design. Jack Donahue, Associate of Applied Science in Information Systems Technology. Mia Alicia D'Angelo, Associate of Applied Science in Information Systems Technology. Aubriana E. Castro, Associate of Applied Science in Administration of Justice. Rhiannon Randleman, Associate of Applied Science in Paralegal Studies. Ebony Monique Thompson, Associate of Applied Science in Administration of Justice. Anthony Alvin Bazemore, Associate of Applied Science in Information Systems Technology. Olivia Stith, Associate of Applied Science in Human Services. Shauna R. Dicker, Associate of Applied Science in Management. Jasmine Nicole Knoll, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Holly Joy Register, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Courtney T. Restrepo, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Emily Paige Phipps, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Charnel Shanae Watson, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Tierra Sheree Barksdale, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Latoya Janae Henson, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Crystal A. Newman, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. McKinla Shanice Reed, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Beatrice Agbakpe, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Rochelle Curlew Scott, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Olivia Lauren Holt, Associate of Applied Science in Accounting. Devin Blake Davis, Associate of Applied Science in Technical Studies, HVAC and Refrigeration Technology. Derek Londell Brown, Associate of Applied Science in Technical Studies, HVAC and Refrigeration Technology. Patricia Shanice Lassiter, Associate of Applied Science in Human Services. Stacy Lee Stubblefield, Associate of Applied Science in Paralegal Studies. William Brimer Kelly, Associate of Applied Science in Information Systems Technology. Alexander Xavier Jarvis, Associate of Applied Science in Information Systems Technology. Leslie Jarvis, Associate of Applied Science in Management. Sebastian Eves Bertrand, Associate of Applied Science in Information Systems Technology. Angela Davis Taylor, Associate of Applied Science in Management. Chelsea Michelle Gibbons, Associate of Applied Science in Management Marketing. Sarah A. Mills, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Joselle D. Matatak Bambao, Associate of Applied Science in Information Systems Technology. David Ryan Allen, Associate of Applied Science in Information Systems Technology. Latoya Danielle Dixon, Associate of Applied Science in Administrative Support Technology. Kimberly Diane Dixon, Associate of Applied Science in Information Systems Technology. Nisa M. Blaze, Associate of Applied Science in Administrative Support Technology. Melanie D. Dickens, Associate of Applied Science in Paralegal Studies. Brian Devon Adams, Associate of Applied Science in Information Systems Technology. Rachel Alyssa Easterling, Associate of Applied Science in Paralegal Studies. Lydia Boone, Associate of Applied Science in Information Systems Technology. Emoleka Ihungwe, Associate of Applied Science in Information Systems Technology. Alexis Nicole Davis, Associate of Applied Science in Paralegal Studies. Joshua Stephen Gibbs, Associate of Applied Science in Information Systems Technology. Elena Kathleen Callahan Baron Shuley, Associate of Applied Science in Emergency Medical Services. Dalen R. Walton, Associate of Applied Science in Information Systems Technology. Andy Bowles, Associate of Applied Science in Information Systems Technology. Kately Kathy Day, Associate of Applied Science in Administration of Justice. Tyrese Yvette Loudon, Associate of Applied Science in Human Services. Yeah. Rebecca David Malumba, Associate of Science in Business Administration. Janae Denise Robinson, Associate of Applied Science in Paralegal Studies. Lakeisha Roberts Drake, Associate of Applied Science in Administration of Justice. Jake Azarcone, Associate of Applied Science in Computer Aided Drafting and Design Technology. Matthew Joyner, Associate of Applied Science in Technical Studies, HVAC and Refrigeration Technology. Denise Ann Sampson, Associate of Applied Science in Mechanical Engineering Technology. Shane Christopher Guy, Associate of Applied Science in Graphic and Media Design. Lisa Jeanette Russell, Associate of Applied Science in Human Services. Vicki Arlethea Johnson Perry, Associate of Applied Science in Management. Garrett Taylor Lahiff, Associate of Applied Science in Human Services. Silver Lee Holt, Associate of Applied Science in Paralegal Studies. Michelle Ann Rivera Cruz, Associate of Applied Science in Early Childhood Development. I got you. Emily Paola Castro, Associate of Applied Science in Human Services. Catherine H. Burrows, Associate of Applied Science in Information Systems Technology. Denise Sheree Morgan, Associate of Applied Science in Human Services.
Torhe Ra, Associate of Applied Science. Torhe Ra, sorry, Associate of Applied Science in Early Childhood Development. Carla Marcella Edwards, Associate of Applied Science in Human Services. Precious Iceleen Murphy, Associate of Applied Science in Early Childhood Development. Anik Mochuang Tamo, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Randy Andrew Jenkins Jr., Associate of Applied Science in Technical Studies, HVAC and Refrigeration Technology. Brandon Curtis Stone, Associate of Applied Science in Technical Studies, HVAC and Refrigeration Technology. Adane Jackson Harden, Associate of Applied Science in Information Systems Technology. John Christopher Elder, Associate of Applied Science in Paralegal Studies. Melissa Shannon Adams, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Jesse Elise Trapno, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Monica Carolina Diaz Garcia, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Kira Lynn Lene Moore, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Miranda Rose Jenkins, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Melissa Marie Graham, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Anastasia Jones, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Jennifer Lynn Newman, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Angelica Lakeisha Davidson Shorty, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Rebecca Lul Fripp, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Raquel LeMarie Edmonds, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Jada Robinson, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Sharita Nicole Brown, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Yvette Lionel Yatembe Galiavo, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Rona Jean Dastos Eugenio, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Michelle Lee Frazier, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Morgan Lynn Sayers, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Haley Marie Van Buren Ryan, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Amanda Rich Bunderson, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Jose Angel Sotomayor, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Elizabeth Grace Whitmore, Associate of Applied Science, Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. May Villacorta, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Joseph Hairston, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. James Ochieng, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Chad Ward, Associate of Applied Science in Information Systems Technology. Michaela Latrice Brown, Associate of Applied Science in Information Technology. Hussinger? Logan Matthew Hussinger, Associate of Applied Science in Information Systems Technology. Joshua Joshua Matthew Lisacor, Associate of Applied Science in Information Systems Technology. Joe T. Pode, Associate of Applied Science in Information Systems Technology. Shavala. Kimberly Dawn Zavala, Associate of Applied Science in Human Services. Toviva Tamara George, Associate of Applied Science in Information Systems Technology.
Laura?
Kendall Laura Height, Associate of Applied Science in Management. Trikaya Imani Fester, Associate of Applied Science in Administration of Justice. Anastasia Kimry, Associate of Applied Science in Dental Hygiene. Lauren Ann Tony, Associate of Applied Science in Dental Hygiene. Skyla Hope Bullifant, Associate of Applied Science in Dental Hygiene. Brooklyn Nicole Inge, Associate of Applied Science in Dental Hygiene. Kaylee Ruth Spadick, Associate of Applied Science in Dental Hygiene. Kayla Chase Christensen, Associate of Applied Science in Dental Hygiene. Nicole Michelle Kiefer, Associate of Applied Science in Dental Hygiene. Bonnie Lee Summer O'Dree, Associate of Applied Science in Human Services. Tamika Nicole Brogdon, Associate of Applied Science in Administrative Support Technology, Medical Office Administration. Latisha Sherelle Holloman, Associate of Applied Science in Human Services. Lamara Spring Arnethia Reynolds, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse.
Shannon Ashley Davis, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nursing. Zoe Allegra Gable, Associate of Applied Science in Professional Nursing, Registered Nurse. Samuel R. Ray, Associate of Applied Science in Automotive Technology. Catherine Joyce Blow, Certificate in Early Childhood Development Assistant. Hajibola Ajayi, Career Study Certificate in Cybersecurity for Local Area Networks. Shokan Kamal Jalal, Career Study Certificate in Accounting. Brittany Brooke Skeens, Career Study Certificate in Accounting. Nizela Ashanti Johnson, Career Study Certificate in Virtual Machining and Design. Levi Connor Cole, Career Study Certificate in Virtual Machining and Design. Drew Ariana Cox, Career Study Certificate in Virtual Machining and Design. Epiphany Smith, Career Study Certificate in Virtual Machining and Design. Trinity Faye Smith, Career Study Certificate in Virtual Machining and Design. Samuel Deering, Career Study Certificate in Virtual Machining and Design. Warren Michael Reedy, Career Study Certificate in Mechatronics Technology. Ariana Marie Overholt, Career Study Certificate in Mechatronics Technology. Danielle H. Hurley, Career Study Certificate in Mechatronics Technology. Paris Elizabeth Stutz, Career Study Certificate in Mechatronics Technology. Joshua Evan Carr, Career Study Certificates in Mechatronics Technology. Mark Makoa Texera, Career Study Certificate in Mechatronics Technology. Andrew Zoltan Kozing, Career Study Certificate in Mechatronics Technology. Mylon Jr. Alexander, Career Study Certificate in Mechatronics Technology. Michelle Renee Hunter, Career Study Certificates in Benefits Program Specialist. Jayla Ely, Associate's Degree, Business Management. Kiana Monet Brown, Career Study Certificate in Medical Office Assistant. Hosanna Viernes Tombega, Career Study Certificate in Medical Office Assistant. Shanae Deneen Fennell, Career Study Certificate in Child Development.
I graduated in 2000, and my current occupation is I work as a Vice President of Technology Solutions.
Hi, my name is Shantae Bell. I graduated in 2018, and I am the Annual Giving and Alumni Coordinator at Virginia Peninsula Community College.
Hello, I am Michael Harris, Class of 2012. I'm the past chair of VPCC Alumni Council, Virginia Peninsula Community College. I am also a lawyer.
I'd like to congratulate the graduating class. It's a great achievement you all have and great career ahead of you.
Congratulations to the graduating class. I'm excited for you.
Congratulations to our graduates. You are officially Virginia Peninsula Community College alumni.
My name is Adana Clark. I graduated in 2018 and my job is a security investigator.
Hello, my name is Chris Stewart, class of 1995, Vice President of Top Guard Security.
My name is Christian Newborn, and I majored in business administration.
My name is Curtis Bethany. I am the vice mayor of the great city of Newport News, and I am a fellow Gator, graduated class of 2011.
As president of the Virginia Peninsula Community College Alumni Association Council, on behalf of the council itself, it is my distinct honor to congratulate each and every one of you as you join a group of 70,000 other individuals that can proudly call themselves VPCC alum.
Although you're leaving the campus, you will always be a part of the VPCC family. Remember to come back to campus, give your time,
your talent and your treasure for the benefit of future students.
Set your goals in increments. It is a journey, and part of it is enjoying the journey. You can't accomplish everything in one go. It's important to take it one step at a time and map out your victories in short increments.
Hi, I'm Mary Kanani, graduate of the class of 2005, and I currently serve at Virginia Peninsula as the Registrar and Dean of Enrollment Management.
Congratulations on the success, beautiful people. You worked very hard to get to this point.
Don't forget to enjoy every single moment. Every moment counts. You know, sometimes you have to weather the storm, but it's a process. So it'll be a process getting to your next step. But take a moment to enjoy where you're at right now. It's a great accomplishment.
Grow where you are planted. Oftentimes we find ourselves in situations or in jobs where we're not using all of our capabilities, but there's always something that we can learn from that opportunity and draw from that opportunity. And so I would say, grow where you are, and after you have bloomed, find your next opportunity.
As you continue on your successes in life, I want you guys to remember to keep a positive mindset. You have everything you need within you to succeed.
Don't be afraid to make mistakes. Be bold, continue to try new things, continue to push yourself, and remember that you're a gator, so you can get through anything.
Just embrace this opportunity. Use people. You have to use each other. You never know. The next person you meet might lead you to your future dream job. So I always tell people to just use each other.
I cannot implore you enough to remember the family that helped you get here, the high school that you attended, the community college that you are now an alumnus of, and to remember that each and every one of those groups is a resource for you and a support system. And please don't just look forward towards future success, but realize what an invaluable role they can play in, you can play in other success.
So continue onward and upward, and be kind to yourself. Set the intentions to love yourself while learning.
And once again, congratulations. I'm proud of you.
Congratulations to the graduates at Virginia Peninsula Community College.
Go forth and be great, and use everything that you learned here to take your life to the next level.
Congratulations, graduates. You've made it. Welcome to this amazing network of Gators, and I look forward to seeing you out in the community.
There is a light inside of each and every one of you that the world is dying to see. So shine your light, and once again, congratulations.
We're wishing you the best of luck and look forward to seeing you again soon.
Congratulations, graduates. You've done it, and your VPCC family is proud of you and celebrates this day with you.
All right, graduates, we have come to that very special time when you get to turn your tassel and join the ranks of Virginia Peninsula Community College alumni. So, if you can, graduates, please stand. All righty. By the virtue and the authority vested in me by the Virginia Peninsula Community College Local Board and the State Board for Community Colleges, I hereby confer upon you the degree of Associate of Arts, Associate of Science, Associate of Fine Arts, Associate of Applied Science, certificates, and Career Study certificates. Graduates, you may move your tassel from the right to the left. Ladies and gentlemen, families, loved ones, Virginia Peninsula Community College faculty, staff, and board members, it is my honor to present you the graduating class of 2023. Congratulations once again. Please take your seats. We have closing remarks, and then we will get you off to your families. I would like to ask the president of our Faculty Senate, Mr. Jeffrey Bonavita, to join me at the podium.
Good afternoon, graduating class of 2023. Most of you probably started your studies at Thomas Nelson, but you're now the first graduating class of Virginia Peninsula Community College. Let's give another round of applause to these alumni. Today I have the distinct privilege of sending you off on the next steps of your journey. Before I do, allow me just a few moments to reflect on your accomplishments. We chose the bridge as our new logo because it's symbolic of what we strive to be, a path that connects you from where you are to where you want to go. Now, bridge seems like a simple concept, but anyone who's ever traveled across the HRBT knows there's really nothing simple about a bridge. And while I do hope that your time with us was more fun than sitting in traffic on the HRBT, we know that getting here was not easy. Some of you came to us fresh out of high school, searching for a way towards an exciting future. In fact, some of you haven't even graduated high school yet. Some of you took a different path through life and found your way here as the next step in a career already begun, or the first step towards a new opportunity. Whatever brought you here, as the first graduating class of Virginia Peninsula Community College, you have not only walked the path, but you have helped us build it. Like a beacon in the distance, you are leading the way forward to an untold number of students behind you. We know that earning a college degree is not a simple task. The pursuit of excellence never is. Homework, essays, final exams, and that's just scratching the surface. We know that you had to invest time, money, and effort. Earning this degree took resilience. We know that for many of you, life did not stop. In addition to being a student, many of you were an employee, a parent, a spouse, a partner, a sibling, a roommate, a friend. And let's not forget that you had to navigate a global pandemic in the process. I also want to acknowledge the sacrifice of the people who love you. Look around the room at the many people who are here to support you. Graduates, can we get a round of applause for your loved ones? To all the parents, spouses, children, siblings, friends, and family out there, thank you for all of your sacrifices for these graduates sitting here today. Now, graduates, take a look down at that piece of paper you're holding. Of course, that's a placeholder because they won't mail you your degree for a couple of months, but pretend for a minute that you're actually holding your degree. What does that degree mean to you? As a faculty member, I stand here hopeful that you have learned just a little bit of the discipline-specific information we try to teach you. But more importantly, what it does is it proves that you've demonstrated the ability to take responsibility and make your dreams happen. Your degree is not just a piece of paper you hang on the wall. It's a reminder that you have the knowledge, tools, and courage to define, pursue, and realize your dreams, whatever they may be. As you walked across this stage today, you've reached the end of one journey. Celebrate what you've accomplished. Look back across the bridge at how far you have come. We know that success looks different for each of you. However, I sincerely hope that as you leave here today, you find yourself closer to where you want to be. On behalf of the faculty, staff, and administrators here at VPCC, we could not be prouder of you. Congratulations, Virginia Peninsula College, class of 2023. Now this concludes the ceremony. Please stand and remain standing if you're able for the recessional.